door was open. Is there anybody home?
There's something on the counter. What was that? I didn't hear anything in there. Thank you. the phone. Hello? Sorry, who is this? I can't understand you.
We can't leave my room.
What the? It sounded like a child. Is he in the house? Yes. Daniel, is that you? That door. Is anybody there? What is happening to that door? That room looks really dark. Mm-mm-mm.
Mm-mm.
Oh, God. Is there someone on the other side? I have to get in there. Finally. Daniel, if you're here, I'm going to find you. Oh, there's a wardrobe. Get in. Is that for real, or am I imagining things?
Yes.
Mommy's really scared. I'm scared too. She's broken all the mirrors in the house. And that song? I hear it everywhere. I wish we had never listened to it. Something is watching us.
Oh.
Why is the front door open? God, I got it shut. Let's see what's up there. Damn it, Daniel, you're gonna kill me. Mrs. Husher, are you here? None of this makes sense. It crashed into the window.
sorry. A few days ago, Mrs. Catherine started sleeping in Saul's room with the children. She's been avoiding me lately. Is she ashamed or something? Alexander and I have lived in this house for 16 years, with her and Mr. Sebastian. We've seen the children grow since they were babies. I don't understand this sudden change in attitude. I saw her playing and reading with the children in the living room last night. They looked exhausted. I could hear it in their voices, but they wouldn't go to sleep. They seemed to be avoiding it at all costs. I had a terrible nightmare last night. Something was lurking in the house. But in my attempt to escape, I couldn't find the main door. It was as if it didn't exist. Or as if I couldn't make it to the entrance hall. The strangest thing is that I don't remember waking up.
I got it shut.
Ah.
What is that? How many of those things are there? You all right?
Oh. I give up. I give up. This place. I shouldn't have come here.
Why is the door open? Burn in hell, demon. door. That door should not be there. I need help! They finally found me. I was feverish, dehydrated, and terrified. But alive. I don't remember much about the ride to the hospital, but I did mumble a few questions about the music box. I had heard it. The endless, grim song it played wouldn't stop hammering in my brain. I would even swear I'd seen it there, on the table, on the other side of the mirror. No, no, impossible. There was no box. It was just a hallucination, a mirage. I needed to rest, that was all. Just rest. Where am I?